Shalom, and welcome to Bible Stories as Blueprints of the Soul, your Biblical Hebrew podcast. Shalom and welcome to our Biblical Hebrew podcast. Today I would like to speak to you about two terms in Biblical Hebrew. One of them is Avel Mitzrayim, Avel Mitzrayim, the grieving of Egypt or the mourning of Egypt. And the other one is Goren Ha'atad, Goren Ha'atad, the granary of the Atad. Both of those terms are associated with the burial of Joseph's father. When Israel died in Egypt, he was 147 years old. Joseph, his son, commanded the physicians to mummify his body. The embalmment procedure took 40 days and then started the process of mourning. The Egyptians and the sons of Israel mourned him for 70 days. And after this period has ended, Joseph started the journey, the funeral journey, to bring his father into burial in the land of Canaan, in the cave of Machpelah, as he promised his father when he was still alive in Egypt. The congregation that left Egypt to escort Israel on his way to burial in the land of Machpelah was huge. Many men congregated together to escort Israel, vehicles and horsemen. When the Canaanite people who were sitting in those times in the land of Canaan noticed a great movement from the east side of the Jordan, because Joseph and the journey came out of Egypt and they were coming to the land of Canaan through the east part of the Jordan. The plan was to come from the east part of the Jordan and then to cross the Jordan west to the cave of Machpelah in the city of Hebron. So when the Canaanite noticed a huge camp is mourning on the east part of the Jordan, they try to figure out what do they see. They noticed that people were mourning. But they noticed that this camp of people who were mourning were coming out of Egypt. So they named this event Avel Mitzrayim, the grief of Egypt, because they noticed people were heavily grieving. And they noticed that this congregation came out of Egypt, so they named it Avel Mitzrayim. Avel in Hebrew, Aleph Bet Lamed, is mourning or grieving. So they named this event Avel Mitzrayim, the grief of Egypt, the mourning of Egypt. But there is also a very interesting term in this voyage. The location of the place. The Bible says that the location in which the Canaanite noticed this great camp was Goren Ha'atad. Goren Ha'atad. Goren in Hebrew is a place in which we take the wheat, the stalk, we beat the stalk, we beat the wheat in a thought that the seed will be separated from the stem, and then we could take the seeds, and in a long process we can make from those seeds of wheat a loaf of bread. So a place in which we separate the seed from the stalk, this Special location is named in Hebrew Goren,
granary
in English. But the Bible says something very interesting. This is not just a general place when we beat the wheat to take the grain out of the stalk. The Bible names this location in the following name, Goren Ha'atad,
the granary of the Atad.
Atad is a low bush, or a low bush which has thorns. But what is the combination of this term Goren Ha'atad, the threshold of the Atad? The value of Atad is 14, 1 to 4. But unlike the name of David, which also has the volume of 14, and the relation in the name of David is 1 to 4, the source and its expansion in space and time, the abstract of the name Atad in Hebrew is 1 to 4, but a 1 to 4 which has thorns, meaning the shell of life. So Goren Ha'atad is a place in which, in an abstract way, the body is being separated from the soul. This is why Goren Ha'atad is located on the east part of the Jordan. Again, Goren Ha'atad, the threshold of the Atad, is located in the east part of the Jordan, because the story of bringing Israel into burial is not just a historical story. It's a description of what is happening to the body when the soul leaves the body. So the body is like a tad, a low bush, which has many thorns. And when we leave, when the soul leaves the body, it's in a place which is named as Goren Ha'atad, the thresholds of the Atad. When the body is beaten out and the soul can finally be free. So this was a little conversation about two terms today. About the grief of Egypt, when people are mourning the body, or this is how the Canaanite perceive the grief of Egypt. When people are grieving the body too much, this is the grief of Egypt, because the sense of Israel, the sense of the soul, is on the contrary, is happy in this day. Like it says in the Bible, and it's better the day we live than the way we are born. So this was a little conversation for today. We wish you a beautiful day and wonderful week.
Thank you for listening to Bible Stories as Blueprints of the Soul. We hope that you enjoyed this episode. If you have any questions, comments, or would like to hear more about a certain topic, just write us an email to Hebrew@learnoutlife.com. We are always happy to hear from you. For more episodes, videos, and articles like this, please visit our website at Hebrew.learnoutlife.com. We also would like to invite you to join our live classes. Just search for Online College of Biblical Hebrew on Facebook and start learning now with students from all over the world. Kol Tov and Shalom.